Welcome back, everyone, to the Misfits, whatever you want to call them. So, in the last episode, I know I said I would try not to do a lot of trades, but I was doing a few things off screen. Nothing major, just changing ex well, changing slides, which I still need to do, by the way. But I was just kind of trying to fiddle around, trade for a QB to see if I could. And I'm like thinking, oh, the 49ers have four QBs available, or three QBs. So I'm gonna just show you what happened for Purdy and Ayuk. Just to show you, because I will do this. Or Desmond King, I'm just like, oh, this might be a possible trade. Okay, that's not awful. And then I added in one of my thirds, a third. And then I went, oh, okay. That's close to accurate. Or that's close to getting it done. And then let's see if a fourth from next year gets it done. I actually haven't done it. That doesn't get it done. Okay. Would a QB that we have get it done? Would. Okay, what if I gave them one of my earlier thirds? An early third and Josh Rosen. Okay, that's still not gonna get it all the way done. Okay, what about Jalen No. Okay, John Ross, maybe? No. Okay, let's try OJ Howard and. My early third. Nope. And I'm probably not actually gonna trade for Ayuk. I just wanted to see if it was possible. Because then this opens up a what about Rasheem Green? No? Okay. I'm not trading two picks for these guys. I don't actually think I'm gonna trade for Ayuk. I just wanted him in there to see if I could. Do they have. I have so many needs on this team. That's so tempting, but also, let's just see. I'm just curious. Yeah, that's what I figured. Not dumb. I just was curious. I'm not gonna try a bunch of these trades, by the way. Ambry Thomas and no, not Jimmy Ward, him. Okay, what if I put in my later third? I'm not gonna try a bunch of these trades, but they this oh God, I don't even wanna. Talanoa Hufanga was on the trade block. That's what kind of started this whole thing. So, technically, he fits into the mold. Okay. Third, what about Josh Rosen? I don't. That got it close. What about adding in my earlier third instead of the later third? We even have. I don't even think we have a good team. HA can? I don't know. I That got it a lot closer than I thought. What if I add in Josh Gordon? John Ross? No. Okay, what if I add in Rager? No. Okay, they do not want any of my people. What if I add in a fourth next year? What if I add, yeah, I can't add in any of my earlier picks, so what if I add in a fifth from this year? Okay, what about a fourth from this year? Actually, you know what? No, I'm not going to try to trade for Ambry. Because there is a cornerback I really want to pick up in free agency who's older. So, makes no sense to do that. Can I ask for a third? I'm just curious. Actually, let me try a set. No. Okay, I guess they have no first. Okay, what about a third? Okay, would a fourth? Does this even go? I don't even want to attempt this, because... Not, like, looking to massively upgrade this team. It's just he was available. Actually, I'm going to show you guys what started this. Strong safety. See, he's right there. He's unwanted by his team. Desmond King, and then add in Mr. Brock Purdy. I doubt this will actually go through, but yeah, okay. So I am going to need to add in a pick. You might say that this is an overpay, but it's an older player. Really? And a seventh. So your new starting quarterback, and probably going to move Petrie to free safety. I'll see how this goes. And your new starting safety for Desmond King, who is getting up there in age. He's good, don't get me wrong. I don't know. Yep, so your new starting quarterback and new starting quarterback, Brock Purdy. And I want to see if Petrie can play. Oh, he can play corner. You know what? I'm going to probably do that. Because... yeah, I'm going to put him at corner too. And then Hufanga is going to be my starter. I know it's dumb, but Hufanga fits my mold better. He's 6 foot. Well, I guess I don't know how tall Petrie is. I'm so used to frickin' Madden. Yeah, he's just a little bit taller, and he's 2 years younger than Petrie, so... There's that. But, got Brock Purdy. Oh. Yeah, I'm glad. I'm glad I grabbed him. He's now the starter for your soon to be relocated Houston Texans, aka the Misfits. And while we're at this, I'm gonna do gameplay sliders just to show you I have not changed anything with the sliders. All the accuracies, everything is the same. Injuries, I am gonna turn down, but that's like the only thing I will. That's the only thing I am gonna change. If y'all have sliders who that'll make it pretty hard on me, just let me know. And then XP. I'll move quarterbacks up to 150. 125, tight ends, 130. 130, fullbacks, 130. I have not done this before, so this is all just a guess. And then 130, 125, 130, 130. So everyone still progresses at relatively the same rate. No. And then I'm not dealing with kickers and punters. If you guys want me to change kickers and punters, feel free to say below in the comments. I am going to play both sides of the ball. I just want to do that for this one. No, where is your... Really? They don't... Oh, that's the freaking Titans. Duh. I definitely didn't forget that. Do we have? Yeah.
Today.
And yes, Lovie Smith is still the coach.
Houston, Texas. It's week one of the NFL.
Do I have the... Are the announcers off? What's happening? Because I don't think I turned the... The music is off, but the announcers shouldn't be off. Oh, and this is on All Pro, by the way. Oh, there he is.
They had no run back on this one, so the new season will begin at the 25-yard line. To the air right away is Ryan. Now a leaping catch, he's got it. And they'll get it up just short of the 45.
I'm not, again, this team is not very good. So I'm not expecting very good results.
Ryan. This will be taken in by Michael Pittman.
I'm expecting this team to get destroyed 90% of the year.
I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons, weapons everywhere, and they want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people, but you absolutely know.
Well, we stopped them for a 3-yard gain. That's probably going to be about all week.
The last run got three. Now here's second and seven. They go play action with Ryan.
Yeah, that was on me. I should have seen that, but I instead went to I was fooled.
Another good reception there, the Colts on the march. A first red zone opportunity of the new year here as they come up now first and 10. Now Ryan, complete, Smith has it. And he gets this inside the 10 to the 9. It's also a gain of 9. Line of scrimmage, the 9, second and about a yard. Complete right back in the hands of Smith. And the Colts are going to be looking at first and goal as they move this down to the 4-yard line. A chance for their first points of the season here as it's first and goal. Taylor is not going to advance very far. He'll be stopped right at the line of scrimmage. Line of scrimmage, again the 4-yard line. Second and goal. Here's Taylor again. And he takes it in for a Colts score. Jonathan Taylor.
Yep, touchdown Indianapolis.
And the Colts are on the board.
We are a 70 overall team. I'm amazed we held them that long.
McLaughlin is up and good. And that makes the score 7-0. Following the touchdown, here's McLaughlin to kick off. Fielded just
holy
outside the goal line.
Holy Jesus, Tavon Austin is fast. Brock Purdy and Damian Pierce.
Now the rookie fourth round pick. This is Damian Pierce. And he'll take this ahead for about four.
Four isn't awful. But
remember, no first round picks this year. They traded it away. How much of a detriment is that?
Well, what they're hoping is the reason they traded away that first round pick, that player, won't be a detriment. He'll be an improvement for their team. And now as you get into the later rounds and the middle rounds of this draft, that's when your scouting comes to the front. You have to hit on those selections.
Pierce will try to pick it up. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 16 yards on that one, and also a Texan first down. First down, it's Purdy. He dumps it underneath here to Lindsey, and they're able to work this across.
I have not changed any of the sliders. The sliders you saw earlier are exactly the sliders I'm using.
And we expect it not to be his last. Very good to get the first one out of the way, though, as he begins his career.
They'll get three as the drive continues. It's a first down.
I am expecting a lot of trials and a lot of
on first down here. Swings this one out wide for Pierce, and the tackle going to be made at the 38. A nice throw right there, and these fans getting their first look at their QB1 of the future. I'd imagine it's got to be a big plus for him to get his first start here in front.
They're they gave it to me. Oh, Josh Gordon.
But I say ride the wave, embrace it. Is going to benefit him in the long run.
And he'll be out of bounds about a half to a full yard shy of the five. A really good pickup of 28 yards. They'll run with Lindsey. And he's in. Touchdown.
Okay.
Houston. Philip Lindsey. A 6-yard touchdown run. And the Texans respond to that opening drive touchdown with one.
Yes. I mean, I don't have any good. I think I might need to adjust the sliders a bit to the computer's favor. I don't know if you guys have been able to hear me this entire episode, but
start their next drive. And Charles, nothing like squaring off with a division opponent, a division rival in week one. Do you like that they are matching up this early, or would you prefer a game like this be a few weeks down the road?
I actually like the early matchup for a few reasons, Brandon. First of all, it allows you to see that the entire offseason and know, hey, right out of the gate, we're playing a division game. Second part is it spreads them out a little bit. If you just have them all bunched up at the end of the year, that's not as much fun watching teams try to survive that gauntlet when you do have injuries down the stretch. And last but not least, let's face it, we're TV people. What a great game to sell right out of the gate.
To throw is Ryan. Open man is Taylor. He's got it. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. It's a 9-yard gain, and it'll keep...
Yeah, I'm not expecting this team to be able to stop wet paper.
First and 10, Taylor now to the 43.
Hey, Hufanga was right there.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out, and they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a 3-yard gain.
And they'll get this down to around the 47-yard line. So on the other side of the field now, it's first and 10, as they've got things rolling on this drive. And he can't escape the...
Quentin Jefferson.
Quentin Jefferson. Credit him with a sack as he buries him for a loss of 10. To try again after the sack. Ryan, a throw on the money there to Doolin. It'll be a gain of 5. And they're going to be staring at a third and long here. A tall task ahead of them here, needing a full 15 yards to move the chains. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. He's got his man. It's Pierce. And they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that. Going on fourth down, it's Ryan. He finds Pierce, it's complete.
Matt Ryan is a... Oh my God, Jesus.
13 there on fourth down. Running straight ahead, Taylor. And able to work his way down to the 16.
We had a chance to stop him, and we still couldn't. That's very... And they've used almost all of the second quarter.
Here's Ryan to throw. That is caught at the 7-yard line. And the Colts are going to be looking at first and goal as they move this down to the 4-yard line. They'll run here with Taylor. And he will push his way forward down to about the 3-yard line. It's a gain of a yard, and it'll set up second and goal.
His first freaking incompletion.
Think about it right now in this season opener. It's third and goal. Here's Ryan. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. Blanketed in coverage by Houston. Makes it fourth down.
Well, our first major stop.
And his kick here is good. And they take the lead here now at 10-7. So a long drive gets him down inside the 5, but ultimately they settle for just a field goal.
And I have to think that if maybe they were a yard closer, that would have made their decision tougher, and I think they likely would have gone for it.
Kayvon Austin, you had it.
To take the three, and it was a smart move.
Houston's offense already at the line, set to get going. They were successful last time finding the end zone on their opening drive of the season. And they'll get another shot here with a first and 10. And they'll wind up getting this to the 37. Gain of 9. It's hurry-up mode time for the Texans, hustling up to the line. On second down, here's Pierce.
Can you tell I am just force feeding Damian Pierce?
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. Delivers another one to Pierce. So back to back plays, each get nothing. And third and one now. Now the Texans will burn the first of their timeouts as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half. Going for it with Pierce. And able to pick up the first across midfield to the 47. First down now, but the clock continues to move. They'll roll him out right. And Gordon's got it. Now another timeout called for by the offense as the clock will stop with 18 seconds to go in the first half. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Here's Purdy on first and 10. Delivering again to Gordon, and he's got him again. Now the offense will burn their third and final timeout. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. So on second down, the field goal unit is on here as they try to get three before half. Fairbairn able to put this one through, and that will knot us up at 10. So a late three there, and that'll help as they head into the break.
Talk about situational football and something they've worked on since the OTAs and mini camps the previous summer. They take care of the ball, get 3 points, knowing they're going to get the ball to start the second half. That's the old two.
If this was any other team other than Indianapolis, I would probably be getting mauled right now.
And with 8 seconds on the clock, really,
but I am still somehow into this in this game right now.
And he's gonna get a good gain of 9 here up to the 34. Now whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the first half. Maybe a good spot to take a shot here, second and a yard from the 34. Final play of the half.
And yes, I'm on the lineman.
It out deep for Smith.
Oh my god.
As we'll get you over to Orlando. All right, we will save the week one highlights and apparently get right back to the action here in the third.
Oh my god. I don't like that. I don't like how that happened.
We are back underway in the second half. Tavon Austin now from the end zone. And he's going to get this across.
Got up to the 23.
Texans offense ready.
This is starting off way too well.
Well, the first half very even. I mean, really in all facets, this ball game tied, Charles. So as we start the third quarter, curious to see what the second half brings us.
Certainly am. I'm with you on that one. And we all know a lot of coaches from the NFL all the way down to the peewee level. They love to spin it to their teams. Hey, we're starting a brand new shorter ball game. It's all even. Let's go out and seize it. This is ours.
And that is incomplete. They work again from the 38 on second and 10. Purdy now to throw. Able to get this to Gordon. And he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. And for the Colts, an extra defensive back in there now on third down. Purdy. And oh, that's going to wind up incomplete. Nearly their first pick of the game, but it does bring up fourth down. Here's Cameron Johnston now. And surprisingly, this is the first punt of the game for either team. And just a net of 31 here. 40-yard punt, 9 on the
return. I love how I speak and then I just get stopped.
First and 10. The Colts come to the line ready to start their next drive. Now this game, it has obviously been all about the defense on both sides of the football. Which offense is going to break through here? Let's see if they can do it on this drive. And he'll manage to pick up about 4 at second down.
I want to be Walker, actually.
Again, it's Taylor. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. Now they're going to be dealing with a 3rd and 7. Is that one officially a loss of 1? Now it's Ryan. It's caught.
I was just a few seconds late, of course, because my player is slow. Probably a run, but... I got bailed out by the game just not registering what that was. If this was any other team, I would be down probably 30 to 10 right now. Or 30 to nothing or whatever.
And his kick is right there. It's good. And they will take the lead at 13 to 10. Well, in a close game like this, obviously you want the touchdown, but certainly they will take the three.
And they'll be okay with that. But let's throw a little credit to the defense as well. I'm just glad this doesn't come down to a debate, right? Which side won, partner? Because the defense, hey, we didn't give up a touchdown. The offense, hey, we put three on the board. Either way, sides gained something out of that drive.
Houston's offense already at the line, set to get going. On the ground, it's Pierce to begin the drive. And up to the 35 before they're able to knock it down. 48 yards rushing now on 8 carries for him so far. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on 1st and 10. First down, they go right back to Pierce. And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple and that's it.
Because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
They'll need 5 on this play to move the sticks. Purdy now to throw off the play action. Escaping the pressure right. And that's caught at the 25. And he'll be marked down right at the 20-yard line.
One of the things that led this organization to commit to him as a starting quarterback as a rookie, his ability to keep his eyes downfield and make plays out of the pocket, able to see the receiver.
And that is caught. What a catch at the 3-yard line.
I am just getting bailed out by animations.
First and goal on a pass play that moves him all the way down to the 1. They'll run here with Pierce. And he'll take this one in for a touchdown.
I'm not complaining.
Damian Pierce with his first career touchdown in his first career game. And the Texans have taken the lead here this third quarter. Fairbairn good with the extra point. And that will make this a 4-point game. So after the touchdown, here's Fairbairn.
I think I need to make these sliders more grueling on myself. And then as the season, as it goes on, maybe adjust them a little bit to be more favorable, but I'm probably going to end up at least trying to make this super hard.
I never met an offensive coach that didn't want to drive to end with a kick. Most of them wanted to end with a PAT, right?
Because this team should not be playing this well. I'm surprised and I'm happy that they are, but like, oh, that was on me. I should have been covering that guy.
Side, this is Taylor. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25.
This is about to be very interesting for it. This is going to be a run, and I'm not going to be able to stop it.
They need just a yard here. It's third and one. And this is going to be caught, but they'll say out of bounds. So it's incomplete. Here we go. It's Ryan on fourth down. And he's got his tight end. That's Smith. And the Colts are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points. Throwing again, Ryan. Looking for Pearson, he's got it.
Yep.
Touchdown, Indianapolis. Alec Pierce with his first career NFL touchdown. And the Colts answer back with a touchdown of their own to take a fourth quarter lead. Extra point by McLaughlin is up and good, and that gives him a 3-point lead.
3 points with 6.5 minutes left.
To kick off. This will be fielded inside the five. And they'll start this drive just across the 30. Pretty nice work on the return. The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. And they will be looking to answer the touchdown their defense just surrendered. Still a good chunk of time remaining here in the fourth quarter and a chance to regain the lead in a tight one. 63 yards rushing for him now in the ballgame. The last run got 9. That leaves him with 2nd and a yard. They go play action here. Purdy. That'll be pulled in downfield by Collins. Touchdown, Houston.
He just thought that guy got bumped.
And the Texans use the defensive breakdown to take the lead.
Yeah, that was a breakdown. And I saw it as soon as that happened. 60 yards. Jesus. And I know this episode's going to be very, 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 very long. But bear with me, guys.
The drive will start at the 25 yard line. Rodgers will not return it. The Colts come
I want to be the linebackers, damn it.
We certainly have a good one on our hands. They're trailing after that last touchdown, but now a chance for this offense to try to snag that lead right back here in the fourth quarter. Officially, it's a 1 yard loss. That's going to bring up 2nd and 11. Operating from the gun, Ryan. Over the middle, and it's incomplete. Complete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. From the shotgun, Ryan. Catch is made here by Irv Smith Jr. And he is going to have a Colts first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Looking to throw, Ryan. Goes right back to Smith again. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45.
This is going to be a good end of the game.
Again, Ryan. On the move past the 40. And he's going to be taken down with another first down as the stop's made at the Texans 39. Ryan. It's caught, Smith. And they're going to move it down inside the 25.
And here we are in the fourth quarter, partner, and we watch them drive for what would be a go-ahead touchdown. And you and I both know this is where you need a quarterback who can keep his cool back there, not just for himself, but to keep the rest of the team relaxed, too.
And he's able to work free for about 6 down to the 18. On 2nd down and 4, Ryan over the middle complete. That's Campbell. And the Colts are going to be set up with a first and goal here as the tackle made at the 9.
Yeah, it's irritating, but you know what? This is fine. Three points with 2.5 minutes. Figured we'd be clawing back from behind a lot.
Fields it right around the goal line. And he takes this near the 25. Just a little pass there. Call it the 26.
So already not the best to kick return. Oh, great.
That adds insult to injury and backs him up even closer to the goal line.
Yeah, not ideal field position to begin a drive, is it? Because the extra pressure now goes on the offense. They got to get some early yards and get away from the shadow of their own goalposts. What every offense wants to do in this situation, get two first downs to help out with field position at the least.
Less than two to play with just a field goal separating these two sides. So it's Texans football as we welcome you back.
Oh, he didn't get his feet in. Damn it. First down.
Here's Purdy. He's got Gordon. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Purdy to throw. He'll get this complete to Collins. Now the Texans will burn the first of their timeouts, as they'll get it with just over 90 seconds to go in the ball game. Pierce takes it straight ahead. And he'll get it down here to the 43. First down now, but that clock rolling. First and 10, it's Pierce. And that play will go nowhere. Losing yardage back near midfield at the 49. A big loss on first down leads to a tricky second down. 18 yards to go. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down. A long way to go here on third down for the eighth play of the drive. They'll look to throw. And this one hauled in by Tavon Austin. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. The defense shaking their heads, not aggressive enough, and they allow them to convert a third and 18. Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
Let's face it, this defense has had its share of struggles all game long, and they know that they can put it all behind them if they defend well here in the two-minute drill. Excellent coverage right there to force the incompletion.
Good.
And his kick is good. And they will tie this game here in the final seconds. So a money kick there in the final seconds. And now, barring any hijinks on the kickoff here, partner, I think you and I, we're going to settle in for a little overtime.
And I wouldn't have it any other way. This has been a dogfight.
Oh, this has been a good game.
No reason to think it won't continue in the extra period.
And with time a factor here late, he'll just take a knee and they'll put it out to the 25. The Colts come to the line ready to start their next drive. Tie game, and barring something incredible here, we're likely headed to overtime.
What I would do is either hand it off inside or more likely take a knee and let the clock run out. Because if I'm back there trying to throw and a sack happens, the ball comes free, I can lose the game here. If I get to overtime, I can still win it.
And here in overtime, if the team that receives the ball scores a touchdown, it's on.
Did everything just die on me? Yeah, Madden just kind of crashed. So thank you all for watching this unfinished episode. let's just see what happens. I'm gonna restart the game.
EA Sports, it's in the game.
I really hope I didn't just lose my entire game because of Madden deciding to crash.
Wow, he just took off on that one and he might have
because
just won the game
if it
for
did,
him.
Well. Okay, I think we're good. I hope we're good.
Welcome back, everyone, to NRG Stadium in Houston.
Okay, we are good. We are good.
Set for a kickoff. So conditioning going to be a factor here. Who can hold up to the test? It's overtime here in week one. This fielded right at the goal line. And he'll be tackled just shy of the 25. Houston's offense already at the line, set to get going. All set up for him right now, Charles. Opening possession of overtime. They've got the football. They also obviously have this home crowd behind him in a big way.
And that didn't count because he was obviously somehow out of bounds and didn't get his feet in. Okay, whoever had that guy, you need to freaking block. God dang. Oh my God, Brock Purdy.
Well, their defense did its job. Now they're going to get the football with a chance to win it.
And it feels like they ran out on the field and right before they did.
This is why this team, oh my God.
We got the situation under control. We'll get it back for you for a chance to win the game. And boy, they did it well.
Oh my God, we're going to lose because
and the Colts will go on offense here. First
it's fine. This is a, what I expected.
Ready to start their next drive. Well, their defense did the job, got off the field without giving up any points, and now, Charles, all they need here is a field goal, and they get the victory.
Yeah, and this is the way I love overtime. I'm one of those really, really old-school guys. They're like sudden death right from the beginning. But we've got it now because any points wins the game. On defense, get a safety, a pick six, fumble return. You can win it as well.
Oh, Harris!
Picked off by Christian Harris. And the Texans are going to take possession of the
football. Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
His first career interception in the National Football League.
And I love what teams do when that happens. Bring the ball to the center.
Oh, my God.
Granted, it puts a piece of tape on or writes on it so you know what it is. And then they tuck it away so that you can have it for later and put it on your mantle. Pretty good deal for him right there. Now he's eager to get back out on the field and get a second.
Oh, my God. Freaking what?
First down, they go right back to Pierce. And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. 83 yards rushing for him now as he was just trying to will his guys to an overtime victory. And another timeout taken by the Colts. And I know you, with every carry, especially in overtime, you're just saying, if you're that ball carrier, hold on to the football.
Hold on to it, protect it, but not necessarily settle it. Because you're trying to get to the end zone. You're trying to end the game right here.
You're defensive guys. Freaking Houston Texans.
Breaking, trying to knock the ball free and protect the end zone.
Yeah, like you alluded to, especially this part of the field. Now, this was not just the opener.
Oh, my God. I can't believe I won that game.
And to come through with a 1-0 start against a division opponent gives you a little something extra heading forward for the rest
of
the season.
Oh my goodness.
One game, right? Opening the season, and you open within the division. You knew the motivation was going to be there on both sidelines. One just executed better and earned the win.
So for Houston, it wasn't always pretty, but they do eke out the week
God, that critical takeaway.
Next week to take on the Denver Broncos. Meanwhile, for the Colts, they obviously fall to 0-1.
I'm gonna look that. Oh my God!
As they get a date with the Jaguars in Jacksonville. And for Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gordon. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports.
Okay, this will probably be cut out, but I can't freaking believe it. This guy is our MVP, Harris. I don't know who you are, Christian Harris. I have to see. Ooh, we'll clap. I have to see who this is. Christian Harris. Is he an outside linebacker? Our 21-year-old rookie linebacker. Oh my God. With 66 catching. Like, how? I'm in awe and shock right now. Well, yeah, thank you guys for, watching. I'm probably gonna continue recording, at least, I don't know what I'll do, but thank you all for watching, and I'll see you guys, next time. Peace.